Still got more to find.
Everything? It is! Let's head back and check in with Izo.
Thank you.
find everything? Excellent. It's all here. Thanks. If you're not in a rush, wait here while I finish up.
I get that it's your profession, but do you actually enjoy this, making weapons?
Of course I enjoy it. That's why I chose this job. Besides, it's the wielder who dictates the true value of a tool. Weapons, too. Aye, that's especially true for weapons. Yes, yes! I've done it! Feast your eyes on my masterpiece! My gift to you, I insist!
I may not be the gentlest owner, you know.
Use her as you like. The wielder dictates the value of the tool, remember? And by association, the value of the maker. Therefore, what good I put out into the world depends on who I entrust with my weapons. That's how I choose to see my part in it all.
Hell of a lot of pressure to put on some guy you just met, don't you think?
The adapter that your friend made. It's a gift in more ways than you know. He was thinking of your future, of what you might do after the dust settles. Today, you may have no choice but to wield a weapon. But tomorrow? Years from now? Think about it if you haven't. The man who fashioned your adapter is an inspiration in his own right. And that's no lie. Maybe one day you'll ask me to turn your arm into a giant egg beater. I'll make it so you can whip up a cake to serve 100.
Weird time to be joking around, man.
Not joking in the least. That's the price for my masterpiece. You owe me a cake fit for a king. So don't you go dying on me. You hear?
Yeah. Talk about a weirdo.
Friendly, though.
True. A weirdo with the heart of gold.
Thank you. Gungaga.
You know,
interested.
This is your friendly reminder from the
Since you're here, I need your help to become a true warrior. Please, guide me to greatness. I'm Sotetsu, by the way, with the GYC. Captain's been singing your praises, you know. Telling everyone how you turned some state-of-the-art Shinra weaponry into scrap metal.
Oh, so you heard about all that? Well, I don't want to brag or anything, but we crushed him.
Really? You have to teach me how you did that. Gotta make Zack proud, you know? He's a friend of mine. We grew up together, hung out and stuff. But I'm sure a soldier like him's pretty busy. We may not be at war, but I bet... To protect the village, of course. And, you know, it might also be kinda cool if everyone in the...
Sorry, no can do. We're just passing through.
Please! I'm begging you!
Wait. Me?
I knew as soon as I saw your throwing star. From the moment I laid eyes on you and your weapon, I just had to... Please, train me!
Oh, well, since you're such a huge fan, one or two... You sure you're up for the challenge?
Of course! I'll do...
Okay, new disciple, meet me over there when you're ready.
Don't worry. I am more than ready to receive your wisdom.
Hey!
Come along. See what you can learn, my second disciple. First and foremost, a ninja must have stamina. So let's see how much you've already got, shall we? After all, a ninja warrior must be able to make a tactical retreat back to her comrades when they need her.
Understood, Master.
Very well. Then with that, let our training begin. I hope you're staying focused, my young disciple. Halt!
Please!
Ah!
ninjas for the trees.
Show me how it's done!
Kiss my ass!
Whatever.
Suck on it!
Stop now! Let's keep up the pace.
This is only your first step on the long and winding road to ninjahood.
Make you proud. Piece of cake.
Bring in the heat! Oh, you in trouble now!
We made it?
I hope you've got more in you, because that ain't gonna cut it. Right, I'm gonna take a quick look around. You rest up for the next round.
I think you should focus on stamina, not strength.
Yeah, Zach told me the same thing. He used to train here all the time. Called it his secret gym. Of course, it wasn't much of a secret since everyone knew about it. But it sounded cool. Hard to live up to the legacy of a guy like that. Check this out. It was his favorite exercise. For strength. Of body. And mind. Start. By training. You're behind.
Not like that. Gotta go deeper. Bend your knees more. Engage your glutes. And your quads.
Got it. Wherever he is, I hope he's doing good.
You cramping up?
What the?
Get back.
Bang bang!
Hang back.
No,
it's still here.
Too bad. Take the lead.
All set.
Want some more? submit!
Did anyone ever figure out what those ugly black ghost things were?
Got all your stuff? Don't forget to try some of our homegrown groceries.
It's springtime, boys! Can I say much better? This is the GYC remote.
So, we just talked it over. And we'd like to ask you to train all of us in the art of combat. Our coalition's only as good as its weakest member, so it only makes sense to get stronger together.
We're really just passing through.
But you could rest here for a while.
Our services don't come cheap. It'll cost you 1,000,000 gil.
That's a pretty steep price, but we could probably manage.
What?
Oh, and he forgot to mention materia. Preferably the precious kind.
That we can't do.
Look, Sotetsu, they may be good at their jobs, but don't you think they're asking a bit much? We're looking for training, not trouble.
If you're looking for someone to train you, then look no further. No money or materia required.
Well, thanks, Cisne. That'd be great.
But what about them? They're veterans of the battlefield, and under their tutelage.
What? My tutelage not good enough? In case you've forgotten, I've seen my fair share of action. If all of you are serious about upping your game, I'll help you out. In fact, I've been meaning to offer for a while now. Seeing as we're here, well...
Sounds good to me.
Me too.
Well, I thought it was a good idea. Sorry I wasn't able to convince the rest of them. It's just, I felt something when we first met. Almost like fate. And I guess I got a little carried away.
Don't sweat it.
Then that settles it. Listen up. There's no backing out now, so be warned. I won't go easy.
Roger! Roger.
Cloud, Yuffie! I know you've got to make a living and all, but you might want to consider lowering your rates.
I'll consider it after you consider paying me! Where's my materia? 3 orbs, or 2, two's good!
Enough already. You're embarrassing yourself.
Just one, dude!
Something happened. Watch your feet.
What am I gonna do about you?
Wow, that's a smell.
We should go. Now.
Wait, don't leave. Treat you guys to a bowl if you help with the ingredients. The pumpkin put up a fight. The knife I've got wasn't long enough to chop it in one clean go. Had to get stabby. And that bulbous bastard. The onion. I mean, I had to close my eyes while I cut it. But that might have been a bad call.
I feel ya.
Gungaga mushroom soup. It smells pretty good all in all. Unfortunately, that's the problem.
Maybe some more Gungaga mushrooms would do the trick.
Let's not.
So, what more do you need?
Oh, right. Torgon's vegetables. That dog's probably parked near the village entrance, selling his produce. You mind swinging by and picking up some of his stuff for me?
What a sweet boy you are, staying behind for me.
You'll be good to Torgon now, you hear?
Did you just pay that dog money?
Oh, him? That's Melon. He comes by from time to time to sell their...
We grow our own veggies here in town too, but the one...
Come on, let's go after him.
Raj, my boy. How'd it go today? Good?
Hello.
Not seen you before. Out of towners?
Just visiting, yeah. So, could we buy some of your produce?
Can't help you. Don't sell to out of towners. Barely got enough for the locals as is. Judging by them duds you got on, you're city folk, ain't you? I ain't about to sell the bounty of my soil to young'uns who ain't never got down in the muck with me and mine. Now get.
I don't know the first thing about farming, but I do know how happy these veggies are. Can practically hear them.
Got an eye for the stuff. But you're telling me you got an ear, too? What's this one saying?
Something about how rich the soil is. How it can thrive and spread its roots deep. Grow big and strong.
I'll be. Oh, quit with the guilt tripping now, will ya? You know perfectly well I wasn't gonna leave them high and dry. We ain't seeing any more customers today, I reckon. So whatever we got left over is yours for the taking.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
They finally learned to talk back?
Shh. We're actually trying to make Gungaga mushroom soup. What do you think we should use? Any advice would be great.
At the risk of stating the obvious, you'll need some quality Gungaga mushrooms. Or better yet, some Maganga mushrooms. They'll take that soup of yours to the next level. Things grow on a hill near here, but unless you got one hell of an eye, better to rely on a chocobo. They're flavorful suckers, so three calves ought to more than suffice. Pick them one at a time, though, if you want to keep your bird from getting all at it. Their aroma can be mighty powerful. And be mindful of the beasties, too. A lot of types are awful fond of the mushroom scent.
Gotcha.
Ah, and you can't forget the salt. Nothing brings out the flavor better than a sprinkling. And Maganga mushrooms being what they are, you're gonna want to savor it. Proper kind of salt for it's got a color close to this. Now, you get them where they need to go.
Slightly different colors. Let's see. Well, one of these ought to match Torkin's picture. What a gorgeous color. Almost feels like a waste to grind him up.
I'd say that's the one we want. All right, I think we've got plenty of salt now. Next up are the Magunga mushrooms. Torkin said we'll need a chocobo to sniff them out.
Down, asshole!
won't be nothing left of you when I'm through! Why'd you give him hell?
I got this.
Behold, the Magunga mushroom. Note its mushroom-like qualities. Just gotta be very careful.
Back to the birds.